Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to quickly create the look of text on a foggy, rainy window pane. It can also be applied to any high contrast graphic. When we draw on a foggy, rainy window pane, we're actually removing the fog inside the surface of the glass. The water drops we see through our text or drawing are actually on the outside of the glass, so they remain visible. I provided this photo of a foggy, rainy window pane, as well as a photo of this nighttime shot of Manhattan, which will add color, contrast, and depth to our final image. Their links are in my video's description or project files. Feel free to use your own photos if you like. To place the skyline into the window pane document, press V to open your Move tool and drag it onto the Window Pane tab. Without releasing your mouse or pen, press and hold the Shift key as you drag it down and release. Pressing Shift kept it centered. To adjust its size, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl-T on Windows or Command-T on a Mac. Go to a corner and press Alt or Option as you drag it in or out. Then press Enter or Return. Next, we'll blur the photo, but to do it non-destructively, we'll convert it into a smart object. Click the icon at the upper right corner of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Change its blend mode to Overlay. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 10 pixels. Open your horizontal type tool and type picker. I'm using Mr. Defoe. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link as well. I'll use a size of 480 points. However, feel free to adjust its size based on the font you pick and the number of characters in your text. Let's make its aliasing smooth, center alignment, and black for its color. Click on your document and type out your text. To angle it, open your Move tool and open the Transform tool. Go to a corner, and when you see a curved double arrow, rotate it. Then press Enter or Return. We'll add water drips to it, but before we do, let's convert this into a smart object as well. Go to Filter and Liquify. On the left are various tools we can use. However, for this effect, we'll just use the Bloat tool and the Forward Warp tool. On the right, let's make the pressure 100, and for this font, I'll use a size of 35. With the Forward Warp tool active, drag areas of your text downward to create the look of drips. When you're done, click the Bloat tool and press on your text to bloat it. Then click OK. Change the blend mode to Overlay. To see our window pane without the photo behind it, simply hide that layer. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.